shut up and listen to me.
No, you listen to me. You're f***ing your family. Because you look at me. You're a f***ing idiot.
Really?
Yes, because your f***ing loves you.
Hey, hey.
You're f***ing standing in my face. Now I'm out of here.
Joe, we're going back to a second base. When we left them, their sales went up to 400%. And now it's losing money again. You know me, Joe. If they really f*** it up bad, this becomes a challenge.
Yeah, you like a challenge.
Which might be a reason to do it. There it is, second base. First of all, the sign isn't even lit.
Blink and you miss it. There's absolutely no sidewalk presence.
I wouldn't even know it was here.
I swear to you, that front of this bar was appealing when we left, was it not?
It must suck to see all that work you put in went to when you left, huh?
And my reputation, because my name winds up being on these places.
Look at that, Joe.
No uniform anymore.
BYOB, bring your own bikini to work. Is that what they had?
Yes! So I want you guys to go in, order all the drinks we put in.
You got it.
Order all the food items we put in. I want to see if they're still doing it the way we spec'd it. Comparing to what you and I left to what there is today, mm-hmm. will tell us everything.
Sounds awful at this place.
Do you have a cocktail menu?
We don't.
You don't have a cocktail menu.
No, we have food.
Well, we definitely want some food. Yep. It's been so long. Don't you have a cocktail, limited cocktail menu that we did?
Do we still have the menu?
Yeah.
When I first saw Joe, I knew I was in trouble. I know exactly what he's gonna order, I know exactly what he's gonna expect of me, and I know I can't deliver it.
I can make you one of them.
Let's do it.
Which one?
See what you remember.
Do you wanna do the Grand Margarita because that's one of our signature drinks?
Nip snap.
She's approachable. And I'm glad to hear that she's the one doing training, but we lost all of those drinks and such, and I've gotta tell you, they gave us an identity.
But that's not the color of a margarita by any means. Thank you. Do you have the other menu, the second base menu?
Yeah, but you're not going to be able to get anything off of it. He doesn't make it anymore.
I can really go for a pastrami sandwich.
We're out of pastrami.
Do you have like a turkey sandwich?
No, we're out of
turkey. Come
on! I mean, that's not my call!
Best culinary ever.
I'll get it for you.
The cocktail program is gone, the menus are gone. You're saying to me that these competitors took it away from you. I'm suggesting you gave it to them.
What is that smell?
I swear it's not me.
It's awful. It is like terrible. I know a few cat hoarders, and this is what it smells like at their house. And this margarita is awful.
It's here, I have it. I wiped off the dust and everything.
Yay.
She doesn't put them out anymore.
Can I order the closer, the bourbon drink? Can I try that? This is just like too much orange juice for me. Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Hey, Sarah.
The barbecue menu, I know you see.
I know, they still want to see it. I don't.
Yeah, but I don't have nothing. Okay, thank you.
I can understand. I can understand all the other stuff.
Terry can't do it by himself. I am not here enough to be able to do it. Terry doesn't care to do it.
It's not our fault.
They're sort of blaming you a little bit here, Terry.
I'm just gonna order a beer, I think.
Bottle or draft?
What's wrong with draft?
Nothing.
Bottle draft.
Got it.
And that's definitely not our forte with the old kegerators.
Hey, Ben.
I'm good, Cabby. How you been?
I've seen better days.
Me too. What happened?
I still couldn't have control of decisions of what I wanted to do.
Is that true?
That's not true.
Terry believes that he knows what he's doing. It's like no matter what.
Okay, so when you yell at me because this beer is not cold enough, then you
was I yelling at you?
Not yet, you're not.
It's pretty bad. You see the bubbles in it?
Nope.
Everything that you taught them, I loved it.
I did too.
But when I hear no one's gonna buy that crap, just sell shots.
That is not even close to being true.
He's not stepping up and making anything better. So I say we go in, let's call him out on it, and let's try to fix this, okay?
Okay.
Let's do it.
Whoa, smell it?
Yeah.
Wow.
Kind of used to the smell by now.
Look at the filth in this place. And this is what Gary is doing to run this place. Let's go talk to Gary.
Okay.
Hi, Gary. How you doing, John?
What the f- happened?
south.
This is go south? What happened, man?
Bigger sports bars moved in as neighbors.
So those bigger sports bars, do they have cocktail programs?
Possibility.
They do. Do you?
No.
But you did, didn't you?
We did.
Do they have good food menus?
Real good food menus.
Do you?
No.
But you did, didn't you?
Yep.
Do they have clean bars?
Yep.
Do you?
No.
But you did, didn't you?
Nope.
Yes, you did. When I left, this bar was freaking clean. And it didn't stink. So why did all this stuff go away?
No money to fix it.
No money to fix it. You think they took your customers, or do you think you gave them to them? So you don't have any pride in the business. Do you give a f***?
Yeah, I give a f***. I put a lot of time in this bar.
I watched you sit on your ass tonight in that back room. When's the last time you cleaned that?
We've cleaned it, but he's got a million other things to do.
What?
He's got the bookkeeping, he's got the inventory, he's got the shift changes.
Is that why nobody knows how to make any drinks? Is that why our beer sucks? Is that why this place still smells? Because Gary doesn't have the time?
At what point do you realize that you're just putting too much in when there's nothing coming out either way? I mean, what is he gonna do? He doesn't know how to fix a kegerator.
But he can clean a freaking light fixture.
Then we have clean light fixtures and still warm beer.
But it's an effort. So now f*** everything, do nothing. Is that what you're
saying?
We've
been trying to do everything that we could possibly do.
What is this stench coming from? Under the floor again? I'm guessing there's mice, filth, bacteria, and water underneath that floor. Gary, this is you know it. The floor stinks, I can smell it. That is the most disgusting I have ever freaking seen. Look at that! Look at it all dripping down here, you can see it! You like it? There you go, man! Right where it belongs! On you!
I did let some things go, but sometimes it gets hard when you don't get cooperation.
And when I look to Terry for help, he's not there.
I want to cut this floor open. Bring in my team, please, Chip! Cut open this floor! What's under this floor? Run off from that drain and run off from this. That's why your frickin' bar stinks. You have one thing going for you. My reputation is on this bar, and that might save your ass in the end, but it doesn't save you tonight. You're a prick.
We got some specialty drinks here.
It's my son, Jordan.
Should be a wine enlistment in there.
You make a good old fashioned. I can make you an old fashioned. Yeah.
Old fashioned actually does not have cherries.
Right.
Like the nachos good or the pizza or the.
The pizza is. It's a frozen pizza.
Oh. Frozen product.
I'm in a pizza mood.
Yes. All right. No problem. Put that order in for you right now.
Chicago's famous for a few things. What's one of them?
Pizza.
Pizza.
So, really? This is what we're gonna do in Chicago? We're gonna sell frozen pizza. So that's Melissa.
I feel so special.
Oh, what is this? Scrambled tofu. And that's supposed to target River North Chicago.
This is my Showtime walk. Wonder Bar! And I'm here! Sugar, doo, doo. High above the clouds, it's just a dream. We're gonna start that norm again.
She can't sing. The sad thing is, if she didn't move to River North Chicago, she could own some little bar somewhere, pay $2,000 a month rent, and she could live her dream playing music.
And be doing it.
But the fact of the matter is, she put herself in a premium space at $18,000 a month, and now she's customers are walking out. So she's been on stage now for about 4 minutes, and they're already leaving.
We want to thank you all for being here tonight at the Underground Wonder Bar.
You guys are all supposed to come.
All right, all right, all right.
Why are you here?
There's another bar downstairs, and then Jordan's gonna do some spoken word, the bartender back here.
This is a two-story venue. Rent is about $60 a foot. So based upon the economics of the bar business, she's gotta do $2 million a year out of that bar.
Jeez. That's why the downstairs is just as important as the upstairs.
Mm-hmm. Let's hope Jordan is better at speaking than his mother is at singing.
Indigenous. I said indigenous people of Chicago, there is no need to swallow the pride that has given us the strive to strive down these streets and fleets for so long. Why, too many of the fields I used to play in are gone. This is just not another sad.
Their stage is right above him. So the spoken word is now the screaming word.
Sounds like my mom is struck back up there.
What the is this? This is your dream, isn't it?
This is my dream.
How's your dream doing?
Obviously, we're in trouble, or you wouldn't be here.
Crayons. Do you have a lot of children that come here?
Yours is a squiggle, mine are some hearts. Someone might have some anger issues.
And what does that have to do with the bar? What are you going to do when this bar closes? You going to draw hearts?
Pretty much. I'm going to stay with my Care Bear stare. Did you ever watch Care Bears?
Come on, this is reality. The audience isn't with you. This is your dream, not theirs.
Well, now I've gone into anger.
Now you're drawing anger lines. That's great. So you're angry because I'm here trying to be honest with you.
I mean, you're trashing my music.
I'm here to make you money. Do you understand that?
Christ.
You want to doodle or do you want to talk to me?
Did you dye your hair?
So you're going to attack me personally because I'm attacking your business? Is that,
where you're at? You're attacking me.
This is my reputation. I've made millions of dollars in this business. I'm here to make you money and help your future. And I am telling you, either pick a dream or pick your money, because you're not going to have both.
I don't trust you at all.
Okay, then I'll get up and go.
Whatever. Stick it.
Lonnie's in debt $500,000, and as long as she doesn't accept reality, she's gonna fail.
Bottom line is we need help. I need her to just take a step back.
The problem is her dream is a bar about her. Her music has made her broke, but she won't let go.
She's so worried about you coming in here and plastering TVs up.
Wouldn't that be terrible if I plastered TVs up in the bar and made you guys $300,000, $400,000 a year? She should welcome anything that makes her money. I'm a businessman.
Yeah.
I'm not here to feed her ego. She wants the art.
Yeah. But...
And until she wants the money, I can't help her. Go talk to her.
Yep. There was no way in hell I was gonna let John just walk out the door. My mom is set in her ways, but what I need her to understand is that we need help.
$5 for both, fellas.
There's a bartender, Emily.
Can I get you guys a drink?
Can I get an old fashioned?
So there's Arlia. She's a bartender.
I'll have a draft beer, please.
Decorations are so different.
Yeah, they are.
Obviously, there's clutter everywhere.
It looks like at times they just slap things up on the wall.
And there's dildos hanging on walls.
No, Cabela, yeah.
Pop it.
Yeah, it may be funny to some people, but after a while, it probably will tire for people.
And it's uncomfortable, to say the least. Look at the foam in that beer. This system hasn't been serviced in years.
What is that? I think it's a baby with... Is that a cockroach?
That's disgusting. Seriously?
So when I look at something like that, it doesn't attract anyone. So you can only lose by doing something like that.
Okay, can I get you ladies? Can I get the raspberry ribs?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It's kind of warm.
Yet it says Youngstown's finest beer cooling system. They don't even have the resources to make it better.
You all right back here?
Yeah, I'm cool, Johnny. All right. I'll call you if I need you, bro.
There's Billy, and he's the cook. look at this.
Nothing, I gotta move my car.
So I've had this place under surveillance for the past 3 nights.
John, he makes that food at home, brings it to the bar, serves it in the bar. I have health concerns about that.
It's illegal to serve food in a commercial environment that was produced in a residential kitchen, because that can't be inspected by a health inspector.
This is really good.
To me, it's great food.
Problem is, he's cooking at home.
And I've got to change that.
You got some work to do.
I do.
I cook. Louis Bailey. He got lazy.
I mean, my brother's an ass, but he somehow managed to make words.
You know what the real housewife is? My brother. John never does anything.
Don't hate.
So there's this resentment back and forth between the two of them.
Mother.
What?
He's out of his mind.
My brother's a pussy.
So these are guys that are losing $5,000 a month and are 10 months away from their business closing. Have you seen them do this stuff? Look at him.
I've seen them like that in the past.
I've never seen this level of buffoonery from a bunch of drunk ass. There's a lot of goddamn buffoonery going on here tonight, and I don't like it.
What a weird.
Jesus Christ, you're out of control.
So look at this.
My recon spies are so uncomfortable, they're actually leaving.
Yeah.
With the atmosphere and the things on, like, on the walls and things like that, it's just not a good look for a bar, and it's just not there.
Could you imagine if your house was on the line and this is how your brother was acting?
Oh, my God, it's not my kid.
I'm not going to let this happen here. I'm going inside. OK, I'm going to work. Nudity doesn't fly.
You're acting like you never had a cocktail in your life over there.
Who doesn't have a shot? Stick, you got a shot?
John, will you just shut the up?
Pleased to meet you.
How much are you losing a month now? Do you know?
I don't know. I don't have anything to do with the business end of this.
We don't make money. In the next couple months, we're done?
Yes. Absolutely.
No. You should wear a ball cap to hide the ball spot.
So is he this much of a jerk all the time? This is freaking serious. And if this is a joke to you, then tell me. Because it's not a joke to me.
And that means you don't take your pants down.
No.
Is this funny to you, really?
No.
This man is months away from losing his house. And you can't even freaking see me, you're so damn drunk.
I am. Listen, this is Youngstown. You work hard, you play hard.
So this is the way you're gonna take care of your family. I won't save your ass when you're like this.
Guess what? Not only will I not lose my ass,
look,
I will
there.
Not lose his bar.
Look in there, see the face of your son? Then drink it, ass.
It's a better looking face than yours. Listen.
Look at me, shut the up. Go sit down in the corner like a child, you ass. I won't deal with this. Get your brother to get his act together, and I'll come back tomorrow. Because he's
I'm
so
sorry.
Drunk, I can't even talk to him.
Hey, before you leave, though.
Go yourself.
Come here and come and do a shot for you, pussy.
What? Laughable, right? The ultimate jerk as he loses his house.
Run, man, run away. Let's have a shot. Tomorrow I'll listen to him. Tonight, him. I'm drinking. I don't give a everybody. I almost. Is today Friday?
Today is Monday.
I lost it. I had a.
Johnny!
Give me a minute.
John, will you just shut the up?
You.
We'll try this. You're okay. Taller than me.
There's the owner, Chandra. In the black.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Oh, that would be better.
What just happened there?
How many shots we gotta buy? We are hustling shots. Oh, wait. We don't want shots no more because I wouldn't like this bar to make that much extra money.
That's Amanda, the manager. What's interesting is there's no uniforms. Some of the girls wear low-cut, sexy kind of uniform.
It doesn't look like she's wearing any pants.
Dirty slut.
In the purplish top.
You are a slut.
Is Cynthia? how she speaks to her staff.
He won the jacking off championship full camp.
The words that she uses.
They all have such nice asses.
Here's your bar back. This guy is named Roach.
That's enticing.
And you guys know that I've had this place under surveillance for the past three nights.
Well, that's her job, is swallowing. Because she sucks too much.
This woman's mouth is unbelievable.
Yep, fat bitch.
Who the hell would work for a lady that talks to them that way?
Topless Lena!
I can't.
She's naked.
I can't.
First of all, this is against the law. They don't have a nudity license.
That was so trashy, I don't have words.
Dirty slut.
God,
this is sad.
This is so sad.
What? What a
slut. The problem is that Chandra is not treating her people with dignity because she has none herself.
We're out of some stuff. It's scribbled out.
Okay. I'm really hungry.
We have great burgers.
I'll get the Hawaiian burger.
Try the Porky's Revenge, please.
What would you guys like to drink?
You know, I think I'll try a hooch.
A hooch? All right.
I'll get one of those, too.
That's fair?
Yeah, start.
Their bar tools are laughable.
That is a novelty cocktail shaker that somebody uses at home.
There's no cap to that shaker. She's putting her hand right on top of it.
So their house specialty drink is just vodka and juice.
It's terrible.
So what do you think?
Whoa. You could tell that nothing was fresh. It didn't work.
There's no real defined cook, which means every item's going to be different.
Yeah. Look at those burgers.
Oh, my God.
Look at the color of that.
We should be seeing some.
Especially frozen from the moisture.
Exactly. There should be some steam coming off at some point. Ew. What are we? She's leaving her gloves on to handle the rest of that burger. She just grabbed the bottom of that refrigerator. Same gloves as getting the cheese.
Cross contamination everywhere.
She's getting raw meat on everything.
Ew.
Sure. Okay. So you guys are kind of falling out there.
I'm sorry, what did you say you want?
What'd you make me a drink?
Porky's? Oh my God, this is humongous. It's already sort of falling apart.
And then don't set it down because it'll slide off.
All right.
That's not positive.
Well, first of all, it's not medium rare. The whole outside feels, it just tastes like very charred and.
Just was cooked frozen.
It's a bit much.
One thing, if you're gonna cook a frozen burger, it needs to be cooked at high heat and fast.
That's appetizing.
She looks like she's chewing on sawdust.
Disgusting.
Cynthia, seriously, how many brain cells do you have?
I'm almost done.
You know how easy it is to do it this way? Amateurs.
It's getting me angry. That's somebody's daughter that she's talking to that way.
Quit being
You could be a
I'm always You're supposed to be nice.
Oh, what a bitch, Tom.
Pretend like you work here now. Go do something.
You know what? Naming this bar the Hooch is kind. It should be named the Gutter. Listen to her mouth.
As soon as they bend over and move their shorts to the side, the whole room smells like dirty skank.
Oh.
Are you serious?
When an owner uses vulgarities, the only customers that will come accept that. So she's alienated 90% of the customers that would be spending money in her bar with her mouth.
Cookers.
She needs to learn to respect them. And tonight, before we go to work, it's starting right now.
You're possibly the most unlikable person I have ever seen. Because your language is unbelievable.
What can I say? I'm an asshole.
And you're fine with it.
I am. That's just what I do.
So you're fine calling them sluts and whores? Are they sluts?
No, actually, they're not.
So why would you call them that?
To cause a callus over them. So that when the fine men that we have in here that we throw out say, come here, you little can I just motorboat you for a minute?
So then if you call them a slut, why wouldn't they call them a slut?
I don't care, because I think it builds a callus.
That's not a callus, that's an ass. Guys, come on over here for a moment, please. Come sit down, please.
That's okay.
Thank you, sir. What does she call you? What phrases?
Guzzling gutter slut.
Really funny.
It's my terms of endearment, I feel.
Really?
Yes.
Do you respect her when she speaks to you that way?
Absolutely not.
Who's the idiot in this room who loses $4,500 a month of her husband's money?
Chandra.
Who's the moron who demoralizes you guys by saying those words?
Chandra.
And you're proud of it.
I am.
Which means for me to come to this bar, I have to accept you degrading your staff.
I don't know if that'll change.
I will not rescue your bar if you disrespect them. I will not do it! Stop her!
Jon Taffer came in and told Chandra what she needs to do. Like, if she doesn't quit degrading people, that's why people don't want to come in here. And if she doesn't change, she's going to lose a lot more than the bar.
You gonna stay out of my kitchen?
So there's Ivan. He's the owner.
He doesn't look very busy.
He doesn't look very happy either, does he?
No.
Wings, fries, burgers, burritos.
There's Sammy. Sammy's the manager.
What can I get for you?
Here's Trista. She's a bartender. She goes out with Sam. They're engaged. There's Lonnie, the bartender. And there's Anjali, another bartender.
We try to make this bar better, and she just runs amok here.
Anjali does that all the time.
So obviously they drink as much as they want. So Anjali's just playing pool with customers.
And she's working.
Get a chance, talk to Anjali, she's playing pool.
To drink in the middle of your shift, really?
Yeah, in between my cooking, Sammy. I'll be right there.
Sammy didn't even try to reprimand Anjali before going to Ivan with his complaint. Clearly, something is off with regard to a power struggle between Sammy and Ivan.
Did you check your stick? Sloppy. Did you point your stick?
Sloppy, this pocket. Did you point your stick?
Do you know how many balls are in this game? Not including the ones in your pants, guys.
A little forward, isn't she?
Might not be good for business, but you're not gonna get me to turn on a bartender for being too flirty.
Martini.
Yeah. I'm gonna have a Manhattan.
Manhattan. We do not have any vermouth for the Manhattan.
No sweet vermouth. Okay.
And then what kind of martini do you want?
Can I get a kettle one?
I don't have a kettle one.
No.
No.
Do you have Ciroc?
No.
Ciroc's really good.
They have no kettle one, they have no Ciroc. Those are two of the most popular vodkas in America.
I have Smirnoff, okay.
Let's do Smirnoff.
Yeah, all right.
Can you make it dirty for him?
Yes, and then a Crown and Gum.
Please. I'll make it really dirty. Look at that. When you pour out of a 1.75, they're gonna pour 20 to 30% more every drink.
Yeah. Smirnoff bottle is 1 liter, and it has a pour spout. With the different bottle sizes and spouts, her pours can't be accurate.
What's your name?
Trista.
Oh, Trista, nice to meet you.
We're gonna get wings.
Okay.
What do you like here?
I like the Forecastle burgers, those are really good.
Okay, all right, you said it. So can I get meaty?
Yes, of course.
Why is the owner cooking all the food?
He can't run his business from back here in the kitchen. So what are those, meatballs?
Those must be sliders.
So he cooks it as a ball and then flattens it to a burger. Had he flattened it in the first place, it would have cooked all the way. Do you realize how long those burgers were cooking on that grill? How well done those are? So he's sauteing chicken wings. That's interesting. Did you see him handle that pan? He can flip in a pan. It's not so easy. His knife skills aren't bad. This guy actually knows how to cook.
He might just be confused because no one orders food, or it just doesn't happen often enough.
He doesn't give a
Hey, Lonnie! Let's get ready to start taking this out, huh?
Oh, wow, how come the food?
Something.
All righty.
So, and everything else is coming out.
Look at that burger.
What the?
Look at that. That's like a piece of leather.
Black?
No, that's the burger patty that's overcooked.
You gotta be kidding me, bro.
You won't even eat it.
No.
Mm-mm.
Sorry, bro.
Mm-mm. Don't do it, bro. Shower.
Spitting it out.
It's red on the bones. Look at it. The chicken's a little raw.
So they couldn't eat the chicken wings. They can't eat the burgers.
Sorry about that. They said the wings are bad. They're raw.
I can guarantee they're not. Give me one. Give me one. I want to see one. I want to see one.
In the trash.
I'll get him.
He's pissed.
Maybe that customer's a bona fide schmuck.
It's not that late for him to be this surly.
15 of you guys out there, let's get this out or it's going to be cold. Let's go. I don't want to hear it. Just put it through the machine.
No, they think you have my.
Those are the extra crispy.
Okay.
Now they're going to come back and say, oh, those aren't crispy enough.
These guys are losing $4,000 a month, and with his attitude, that'll never change.
You guys get this right, or next time you're wearing it.
I mean, I've never seen anybody speak to a staff that way.
It's going to be such a depressing workplace.
Any day now.
Have at it. I'm not going back there.
See, they don't like him. You blame him?
No.
You have another order of chips and
I don't want to hear it. Just put it through the machine. So you don't talk to me. Ever.
The disrespect that Ivan has to this staff is unbelievable. His attitude affects everyone.
How you doing, sir? Ivan Vujic.
Jon Taffer.
Jon Taffer.
Nice to meet you.
Heard about you.
Well, you're dressed for success, aren't you?
Hold on, let me button up.
How much money you lose this month?
Oh, probably $4,000 to $5,000.
$4,000 to $5,000. Yeah, this is how you try?
This is how you fail.
And how many times did you tell your employees to go f*** themselves tonight?
Probably 150.
How many times did you call customers and f*** tonight?
Probably 20.
Somebody comes in here, orders chicken. It was raw, correct, Sam?
Yes, sir.
And the customers and for sending it back.
Yeah, something like that, yes.
Everything is everybody else's fault, right?
Yes.
Whose fault is it really?
His.
His. Who's in charge of this place, girls?
Ivan.
Ivan, are we clean?
No.
Do we have the products we need?
No.
Does he treat you with respect?
No.
Who was the Sam?
Ivan.
Ivan was the
Yeah, but you're acting like an right now.
I'm leaving. Good luck, guys.
Bye.
Ivan.
What a you are.
You gotta be a like that.
Ivan. Why would you? Are you serious?
No. Go talk to him.
You're not talking to nobody.
Ask him to come back and help
calm
us.
Calm the down.
No.
Calm down. Get the off.
Go
me.
Talk to him. Just go.
We're trying to save this place.
Ivan had the opportunity of a lifetime, and he just blew it.
So that bartender's name is Amber.
The Chester Wrap. Why is it called a Chester Wrap?
So the owner named it Todd Chester.
Signature item. We've got to do it then.
All right. I want to try this, the Night Rod.
We have to make sure we have them. I'll be right back.
They don't have enough product.
Even though they knew when they were going to open.
That's what you do when you set up for a shift. The first thing is making sure you have all of the ingredients for the cocktails on your menu.
They're completely disorganized in the bar. They're not even putting any of the bottles back where they got them from.
Okay, guys, there's Todd dressed in the black directly across the bar from you. He's one of the owners of this bar.
Look at him chugging down booze at the end of the bar.
This was the Night Rod.
Oh, yeah.
Ready? Cheers.
Bing.
What the hell is in there?
I think I taste spiced rum, vodka, tequila, gin. An array of juices, sweet and sour, and cola.
They don't understand balance.
Okay, Mia, there's another bar outside. Go over there and try one of their drinks.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Yes.
Do you have a bar outside?
It's the softball field bar separately.
Where is that?
So if you want to walk down that way, go through the back.
All right, thank you. Okay. Get out there, darling. Do your thing.
I am headed out to the bar that's halfway across the softball field from this bar.
So Mia, the second bar by the softball fields is run by Scott. He and his girlfriend, Linda, operated completely separately from the bar inside.
Okay. Do you do drinks out here?
I do.
Our specialty drink is a slut hut special.
The slut hut. I'll do one of those.
All right. Is that it?
Yes, please.
Okay.
Thank you.
How's that drink, Mia?
I'm trying to figure out a place where I can secretly dump this.
This drink? No bueno.
So this is the Chester Wrap?
Talk to me, Vic.
Oh my God, there is hair in the food. You ever have this one?
Uh-uh, I've never had a wrap here. It looks like it's brown meat. It looks like it's something hanging on.
I gotta talk to you. I just wanna let you know that there's hair in the food.
Super sorry, guys.
Unbelievable.
Okay, thank you very much. We apologize. Hope you come back. Yes.
How long have you been cooking?
my fault. Huh?
Yes, sir.
Please, help me out. Help me out.
Thanks, guys. I think I've seen enough.
Let's get the glass off the table. We're about to burn.
So what's going on right now?
They're burning the picnic table.
Hey, Angie, get her going.
You're going to have to replace that picnic table.
Yeah.
And what will that cost you?
$150, $200.
Hands up!
Your husband is smiling. So he's saying you to Scott, you to your family. That's what this guy is doing.
Hands up! We have people riding through.
If you see all that going on, all the smoke, whatnot, I don't want to be in the atmosphere that he's creating with that side of the bar.
Boys, come on, Chad. Come on, Chad.
What are they doing now?
Come on!
They'll do a burnout on the table.
Do it! Do it! Yes!
I remember my
free!
Who would want to bring their family or even just some of these ballplayers? You know, who wants to go in there and into that mess?
You understand how this will chase people away?
Yeah.
So it's either this or your family.
Hey, you got a plate on a table here?
It's either that he accepts some responsibility or your family keeps paying the price for his irresponsibility. At least you're guilty for this, too.
I agree, definitely.
You need to fight for your family. This is absurd. I want you to get him, and I want to talk to him and you alone. Okay? Let's go get him. Elise is sitting and crying next to me, and they're playing like children. I'm gonna go in and stop this. So I'm only gonna talk to Todd tonight, get his attitude straight, and then I can talk to Scott tomorrow.
Hey, Elise. You need to come with me.
All right. She's watching you do these burnouts and applaud, and we're watching you act like a child, Todd. You're smiling.
No, I'm not.
New attitude.
No.
Listen to me.
You're losing $6,000 a month, right?
Yep.
So, what the are you doing? Do you think that you can make money by burning your own furniture? What did that table cost? $160 that you're not gonna give to your kids?
Don! Shut up and listen to me.
No, you listen to me. You're f***ing your family. Because you look at me. You're a f***ing idiot.
Really?
Yes, because your f***ing wife loves you.
Hey,
your now I'm out of here. Todd is the catalyst of the failure here, and he proved it tonight. He's drunk, he's unreasonable, he's violent, and he's acting like a fool. I'm gonna get the hell out of here, and I'll come back tomorrow. Hopefully Todd is sober.
Someone's here to help this bar.
Then where is he now? He's not here. Did he leave? Did he just vanish?
You need to listen to what is being done wrong.
Listen!
You think your buddy's coming in and wrecking a table is funny. It's embarrassing. This is embarrassing. This is what is embarrassing. Not me. Not me trying to get my husband up off the ground. It's you. You're the one that's embarrassing. So stop with the nonsense and run a business.
All right, thanks. That would have been a great opportunity to offer me a menu.
You want a drink?
No, I'm good.
Come on.
You don't have to force people to drink, you know?
You have
to. No, you don't.
John, look at the wash line on that cocktail. There should be about a centimeter between the top of the glass and the actual liquid. We're getting short poured here.
I'm going to try and drink some of this vodka. It does taste a little bit watery. There's a little statue there behind me.
Nothing about that statue says Morocco to me.
Never, you'll never see one.
Gazi keeps popping peanuts.
I was just gonna say, I don't get the peanuts.
How does peanuts play into the Moroccan thing?
Here we go.
Look at these belly dancers.
Wow. It doesn't look Moroccan.
These are just girls in costumes moving their bodies around.
It's definitely like a fusion belly dance thing. Some lovely belly dancers behind me.
The LED lights is something you don't see very often in Morocco.
That could be on the strip in Las Vegas. Right.
And no one's paying attention.
No, it's so uncomfortable.
Right.
How long have you been sitting here?
I think about 15. We've been sitting here 15 minutes.
Make me my drinks.
Come on, don't complain.
We'll do it for you.
No, but they don't.
That's why we have service in here for.
So they can't get a menu, but guys, these friends seem like they're taken care of.
Yeah, I love it. What are you drinking? Okay, I'm gonna get
4 beers for everybody. Yeah.
Okay. No wonder they're failing. Ghazi's giving everything away.
Can we trouble you for a couple of menus?
Menus?
Yes.
Yeah, thank you.
You want beer? No? Okay, I'll get you one.
This is like Ghazi's basement.
Is this all pre-prepared?
No, it's fresh.
It's all made fresh?
Yeah.
Ask him to say, do they have a tagine?
What is a tagine?
It's couscous or rice topped with different kinds of stews.
That
says Morocco.
Order a tagine.
Tagine.
How about a tagine?
What the tagine?
The Moroccan national dish. We want to try every starter on the menu.
Great.
Okay, thank you.
This is so weird. So weird and dirty.
There's Bobby. He's our cook.
Okay.
Now look at that disgusting cutting board.
Oh my God.
What worries me is he has raw product all over his hand and he's touched the rib of every bowl.
So there's a lot of cross contamination happening.
Oh.
Oh my God.
Falafel, you know the falafel?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Fried cheese bowl?
Yeah, yeah.
Chef, are you comfortable with them eating that?
No.
They can't eat that contaminated food.
No.
Tapa, rabar ganoush, grape leaves, hummus.
Don't eat any of the product.
You said don't touch the food.
Don't touch the food, guys. It's going to make you sick.
I'm going to stop it.
Is that a hair?
It's a hair. There's a hair on my plate. See, I taste the cheese thing looks doused in oil.
Hey, guys. Let's see what we got here.
There's the falafel balls.
Look at the dryness of that. Do you want to eat that?
No.
Do you expect me to eat that? Take it away.
Okay.
Thank you. That's disgusting.
What's wrong with it?
It's hot. Take it away.
All right, I'll go, doctor.
I didn't try that.
Sam? This is so hard. I could use this for self-defense.
But that's the way it's supposed to be.
Why don't we go talk outside? Okay? Thanks, guys.
There's nothing Moroccan about this restaurant. If John hadn't invited me and Alexander to come down and check this place out, there's no way I would have found myself here.
Ghazi,
pleasure. The food sucks in this bar, and the kitchen practices are completely unsafe. Nobody should be eating this food, and these brothers just keep arguing with each other. They can't even get out of each other's way. I want to sit down and talk with them and break this stalemate. So, you buy this place together. You're losing $8,000 to $10,000 a month. How's that working out for you?
20 years of a brothership, me and him, we're going to lose it over this restaurant. That's what I'm afraid of.
So how do you feel when he walks around a restaurant giving drinks away?
I feel like
I want them to feel special so they come back.
So that's how you make them feel special, by giving them a free drink?
So how much does he give away every week?
Almost what we're losing.
He gives away the $8,000 to $10,000 a month.
Yes.
At what point do you say to yourself, it's not working?
It's working because we're supposed to lose 20. That's why I minimize it to lose 8. I'm working to make it 0. But you gotta help me.
How long is it gonna take?
You have to have patience a little bit.
I can't have any more patience.
You see why you're failing?
I think that's
right. No, here's why I'm failing.
If you think I'm an idiot and you think the place is losing because of me,
just leave me alone with the customer service.
Go ahead and run it yourself, okay? Enjoy it.
Until you come together, you cannot succeed. You're both idiots. Ghazi and Sam will not stop arguing with each other. They need to get this out of their systems so I can come back tomorrow and try to talk to them.
Maybe Jon cannot even fix a problem.
Give me this. Go get another one.
But as long as he keeps going like this, we have no hope.
Hi, this is Jon Taffer. Click here to subscribe to Paramount Network on YouTube for more Bar Rescue.